Put that in the fire pit, Cali. Thank you. Beautiful morning here at the cabin, and I'm just about to get started clearing the site to get working on the outdoor cabin here, and getting the odd black fly bouncing off the camera. So this is going to be my biggest challenge over the next few weeks, is not only living in the forest with the bugs, but working outside trying to work around them. But my biggest challenge is actually going to be filming. So, you know, I tout overcoming challenges and working hard and taking the path of more resistance as some of my mantras and some sort of habits or techniques to get through life successfully. But the reality is, the more I do this, the more I discover that this is my path of least resistance. So even though I'm working hard physically and I deal with things like weather and insects and other wildlife, the most challenging part of my life was working down in the city, traveling 2.5 hours each day just to commute to work, and then dealing with people in a business environment. To me, that was not my nature. It was not my true nature. So I found that was more challenging than this. So even though literally I would jump on a train or jump in my truck and travel for a couple of hours each way for part of my working career, and then just sit in boardrooms and offices and things like that. So no physical challenge at all, and not even all that much mental stimulation for part of that time. That, to me, was kind of life-sucking. It was life-draining, and it was a path of more resistance for me because it wasn't my true nature. This seems like a daunting task, a daunting challenge for most people. Maybe they don't feel like they're up to it, but I'm sure you have lots of challenges in your life that you're overcoming, and maybe I couldn't. Well, I look at your challenges, and I think they're overwhelming, and I'm not sure if I could go through those. But the reality is people are very resilient and powerful when we put our minds to it. But when we're following our true nature, when we're following our passion, we actually find that the challenges are less daunting and less seemingly impossible, and that we're able to overcome them, and that we're able to require less willpower, in fact, because the temptations that are out there that we have to try to overcome, if it's too hard to try to overcome those things, maybe that's the wrong path. Maybe we should be looking for a path with less obstacles, not because it's easier, not because it's the path of least resistance in a lazy way, but it's the path that's our true nature, and our true destination lies at the end of that path or along that path. So I wanted to say that quickly before I get to work and start dealing with the heat, with the sun coming up, with the bugs, and whatever other challenges I find throughout the day. So anyway, that's my message for this week. I really appreciate you tuning in. Thanks for joining me and Cali at the cabin. Take care. Have a great week, and I'll see you up at the cabin shortly.